Hello friends, I'm Dr. Vikas Maurya, Director and Head, Respiratory Medicine and Interventional Pulmonology in the Department of Pulmonology and Sleep Disorders, Fortis Hospital, Shalimar Bagh. So here I'm about to tell you, you know, what my department is. So as the name suggests, we are managing routine respiratory patients and sleep disorders patients, but we're also doing a lot of interventions. So what are those routine respiratory patients, you know, like apart from managing asthma, COPD, interstitial lung diseases, lung cancers, pneumonia, pulmonary embolism and other various type of lung diseases. We also do routine daily OPDs, we have inpatients and we also see acute emergencies and also see very severe patients like ARDS in our ICUs. You know, interventional pulmonology, I think it's a unique thing nowadays, and our department is well equipped with majority of this interventional pulmonology procedures. In fact, we are doing all. So what we are doing basically is interventional pulmonology, if we say, is subspecialty of pulmonology, in which we do various minimally invasive procedures which are done endoscopically as well as percutaneously, not only for the diagnosis but for the treatment of various cancerous and non-cancerous diseases. So now, starting with the diagnostic interventions which we have very well advanced video bronchoscope, and we do various diagnostic procedures like lavage, we do routine transbronchial lung biopsies, we do endobronchial lung biopsies, we do TBNA, that is transbronchial needle aspirations. Then apart from this, we do regular medical thoracoscopy, which used nowadays very frequently for pleural biopsies, for biopsy of other the cancerous tissues. And we also do EBUS. We also have endobronchial ultrasound, which is used to do fine needle aspiration of the lung masses, the mediastinal masses, that is tumors, and also of the lymph nodes. We also do CT guided procedures, and we do CT guided FNAC as well as biopsies of lung as well as pleural lesions. So apart from these diagnostic interventions, we do regularly therapeutic interventions as well. So for this, video bronchoscope is used for most of the therapeutic interventions. So what kind of we are doing? We are basically doing tumor ablations, of the tumors which are there in the trachea and bronchi. This is being done by use of cautery, like we have electrocautery, argon, and the laser, so which is being used to treat those tumors which are obstructing the airway, and by this patient can be relieved of the symptoms. We also do stenting. Stenting is being done nowadays both with the fiber optic bronchoscope as well as rigid. So we have a rigid bronchoscope here as well. And airway stenting is done in patients who have an obstruction in the airways, whether it's in the trachea or in the bronchi, they are not able to breathe, they are having cough, they are having pneumonias. So that can be treated therapeutically with the airway stenting, and we clear up the obstruction. We also do regular airway dilatation of stenosis. For example, sometimes patient have stenosis of the airways, maybe trachea or bronchi, which can be done with the balloon dilatation of these stenosis. We also do regular foreign body removal with the help of video bronchoscope as well as with the rigid bronchoscope. And we also do a whole lung lavage, which is done in cases of pulmonary alveolar proteinosis, which though is very encountered, very, very less, but it is still can be done in our hospital setup. We also insert the chest tubes for large pleural effusions. Maybe it may be a malignant or maybe a non-malignant one. And in case if there is a persistent pleural fluid drainage, we sometimes also do routinely do a tunneled pigtail catheter or a tunneled catheter for these large pleural effusions, which are most of the time are cancers. So these are basically the procedures which we are doing in our the department. And if you can see, majority of interventional procedures and almost all procedures are being done by us. So our department is unique, and it is well known in our area, in Delhi, in India. And so whenever there is a problem with the patients and everything, they do come to us and we get relief, not only of the symptoms, but we also do a good diagnosis as well as a treatment. Thank you.